Hello. Let's have a look at database and structured query language SQL. Database is an organized collection of data, whereas DBMS, database management system, is a software that manages databases. A popular variety of database is a relational database, RDBMS. Relational databases model data as rows and columns in a series of tables. Tables are also known as relations. This relational databases support SQL for writing and querying data. So let's have a look at this SQL, structured query language. Let's imagine there is some data which is stored in a database. So if you want to get data from that database, first what you need to do, you need to connect to that database. To connect to that database, you have to provide your username, password, your credentials. After connecting to that database, you can access whatever data is inside it. So let's imagine your database is connected and there is a table, customers table is inside it. The customers table is having 5 columns: ID, name, age, address, and salary. There are 7 rows, row ID 1 to ID 7, there are 7 rows. These are already entered and stored in the database by someone. Now what we want to do is to retrieve this data. To retrieve this data or to display this data, what you should do? You should write a query, select query. So select query for fetching all the data can be written like this. Use the keyword select. Select star, star stands for all columns. Select star from customers. If you write select star from customers, you will get this display data. By chance, if you want to select only name and address, only 2 columns, name and address columns only, name containing this Ramesh, Kilan, Kaushik, so on, address containing these data. So if you want to display data in only these 2 columns, then you should customize this select query. Select, instead of column 1 you should write name, instead of column 2 you should write address. Select name comma address from, instead of table name you should write customers. Select name comma address from customers. So let's make a note. So always queries are terminated with a semicolon. So this is about retrieving data. If I want to store some data as a column, if I want to store some data as a table in the database, what I should do? First I should create a table. Create a table, you can use create statement. Create table, name of the table, then you can write series of column names and their data types separated with commas. For every table in the database, you should specify at least one column as primary key. You can specify primary key at the end of the table or directly during the declaration of column 2 data type and then primary key. You can specify the constraint right here also. So this is about creating table. Let's have a look at one example. Create table customers. This is how that customers table is built. Create table customers, open bracket, then column name, ID, its data type, it was accepting numbers, hence int, not null, ID is required, hence. And next column, name, this requires text data, hence varchar, how many characters you want to store, 20. Age, int, address, character, if you want to store fixed number of characters, you can use char data type. Salary, decimal can have numbers with the fractional part. how many numbers you want to store, how many fractional part you want to store, and then you can specify which column is primary key. Bracket was opened here, bracket is closed here, and a semicolon. So this is how you create a table. If you execute this statement, and after that, if you want to look at the structure, you need to, you can use describe statement, DESC, customers. Now we have created a table, we want to feed data into that table. Then what we should use, insert query, insert into table, insert into our table is customers, insert into customers. Then you can specify which columns you want to insert, for which columns you want to insert the data. You can write ID, name, address, so on, and then values. Values keyword is used to supply the actual values. Insert statement can insert one row of data. So for that row, you can specify data for each individual columns. So here, if you want to create this table, the first row, then that is 1 Ramesh 32 Ahmedabad 2000. So here inside this values parenthesis, you have to supply 1 within quotes Ramesh, then 32, address Ahmedabad, and salary 2000. So all these values are separated by commas. Let's make a note of another point. If the data type is not integer, then you need to specify the values Ramesh, such as values such as Ramesh, that should be enclosed within the quotes, single quotes or double quotes. Let's have a look at an example. Here it is. Insert into customers, ID, name, age, address, salary, these are the name of the columns. If you are supplying the data in the same order as in the actual order of in the table, then you don't need to specify all these column identifiers, you can directly supply the values. So values 1 comma Ramesh 32 Ahmedabad 2000, so on. You can create many other rows also. Now suppose I have specified a value by mistake, I have made a mistake while specifying the values, then what I can do, I can use update command to correct my mistakes, or the, by chance there is a change in the data, you can introduce that change using update command. So update command can be specified in this way: update table name set. Update is a keyword, set is another keyword. Set column number 1 is equal to value 1, comma column number 2 is equal to value 2, comma so on. So here after the set keyword, you will specify which column you want to modify, and the column's value which should be set, that will be specified here. What happens if you specify only these two things is update table set column number 1 is equal to value. So then all the entries, all the rows in which columns value will be set into value. So to prevent this, the implication is if you say set name is equal to Ramesh, then all the rows will contain the name Ramesh. To prevent that, you can use where clause. So using where clause, you can specify a condition. You can say update customers set name is equal to Ramesh, where you can specify condition ID is equal to 1. So let's have a look at one example. Update customers set address is equal to Pune, where ID is equal to 6. So where ID is equal to 6, we should look at this row, ID is equal to 6, where is that? Here. So in this row where ID is equal to 6, set address. So address column, this is address column. Address column in row 6 should be set to Pune. So instead of MP, value Pune will be set. So this is about updating. So these are commonly used queries while we interact with the databases. There are many more. You can refer to good references such as Tutorial Point or W3 Schools, and you can look into many more queries. They are interesting and easy. So I will share these links below the video. Thank you.